Hello, in this tutorial I will be going over how to download and install Qt with the preferred options for getting started. In this case, we will be installing the main compiler and all available modules for the latest release at the time of recording, which in this case is Qt version 6.2.3. First, go to account.qt.io, type in your username and password, and click sign in. Once you've signed in, you'll be greeted with the following page where you can access license information as well as create a support ticket. To download the Qt Online Installer, click Downloads on the menu on the left. Here you will be able to select a number of products to download. In this case, we will be downloading the Qt Online Installer version 4.3.0. You will likely find that this is the default selection. However, if it is not, you can select it from the drop-down list. Once you've made the proper selection, click Download. This should only take a few moments as you are only downloading access to the Qt Online Installer. Once downloaded, go to the Downloads list in your browser or your computer downloads folder and open the installer. The first page will ask you to log in to your Qt account. Sign in with the same username and password as before and click Next. Since you have a commercial license, you'll be greeted with the following screen. If you see something other than what is shown, fill out a support request and we'll rectify that for you. Otherwise, click Next. This will quickly download the metadata needed to show what Qt version and other products you have access to. The next page allows you to select whether or not you would like to send usage statistics from Qt Creator to the Qt company. I will personally enable this option, but feel free to disable it if that is preferred. You will now be prompted to select the folder where you would like to have Qt installed into. I will leave this as the default location, but any folder will work. Below this, there are a number of different options to choose from, the easiest of which is to select Qt 6.2 for desktop development. This will install the latest version of Qt for the main desktop compiler, as well as the optional modules that comprise this version of Qt and the latest version of Qt Creator. If you are starting off completely fresh, this is the ideal option to select. However, if you want more control over what is to be installed, then select Custom Installation. For the sake of this tutorial, I will select Custom Installation and install the equivalent of Qt 6.2 for desktop development. The next page has a number of selections, so I will not go through everything in detail, but instead summarize some of these options. Archive contains all older versions of Qt that are no longer supported, or ones that have since been replaced by newer versions. LTS contains the latest long-term supported versions of Qt. Latest Releases contains the latest releases of any supported version of Qt, which will include the non-long-term versions as well. Finally, Preview is for releases which are currently in beta and release candidate stages. You can change what is listed here by selecting the desired items by checking its corresponding checkbox, then clicking Filter. By default, Latest Releases and Preview are displayed. This is typically all you need if you intend to use more current versions of Qt, so I will not be adjusting what is displayed as we will be using the latest release of Qt. I will now explain how to select and install Qt 6.2 for the MinGW compiler. First, expand the Qt entry shown here. Then, expand the latest non-alpha or beta version. In my case, this is Qt 6.2.3, but you may have a more updated version depending on your time of install. This will list all the platforms you have available, which can be used from the computer you are installing from. So, on Windows, if you have the proper licenses, you can install the pre-built versions of Qt for WebAssembly and Android in addition to Windows Desktop. Now, select MinGW, and since we want all extra modules, put a tick next to each Qt module as well as additional libraries as shown. As you can see, there are other options here which will allow you to install for other compilers, but in this case, all we want is MinGW with all available modules. Next, we'll be taken to the license agreement. Since I'm already aware of this agreement, I will check the box and click Next. We can now select the Start menu, which we want to create the program's shortcuts. Again, I'll keep this as the default, but feel free to change this if you would like. Then, click Next. Finally, we're ready to install. You can simply click Install and the process will begin. This will likely take some time, so be patient. I will, however, cut to the end of installation. Once the installation is complete, you will see this window. Now, all we need to do is click Finish and Qt Creator will open up automatically, allowing you to begin work on your application. If you ran into any issues throughout this process, please fill out a support ticket via the Support Center on accounts.qt.io and we will be happy to resolve your issue. Thank you for listening.